Greetings from Iceland. I am here visiting the plane wreck in the south coast region in Iceland, and if I'm not mistaken, the area is called the Sólheimasandur beach, and this plane wreck is one of the main attractions here in this region. Just off the road, if you are on your ring road trip, just off the road there is a parking lot for the plane wreck. You know that plane that you see on a postcard, the famous plane that crashed on the beach? And I am now here on my way to that plane, and I'm not sure if there is a bus that takes you to the plane. It's gonna be a big walk, I would guess, to the plane. And let me see, this is the entrance, and here we go. And basically where I'm gonna go to see this this plane wreck. And and if I'm not mistaken, I heard that there is a shuttle that takes you from this point all the way to the plane. But I see a bunch of people walking off in the distance, and I also see a bunch of cars in the parking lot. That shows that I am not alone here. So because sometimes when you go to when you go to off the beaten path places, you know, sometimes you wonder, if you get lost and you don't have anybody to ask. And I am on my way to the south coast to visit all the attractions along the way. And this is the third destination in my southwest coast region trip. And earlier I visited the Skogafoss, and in the morning I started with another waterfall called Sólheimasandur. No, I don't think that's how I pronounce it. I'm gonna put it on the description. So many waterfalls here. There is no shortage of waterfalls. But anyway, I am on my I'm doing the ring road trip, and today is my today is what? Today is Wednesday, and I think today is my fourth day, and I'm headed to the south east region tomorrow. So I'm gonna have a bunch of activities, and then after that I'm gonna head east and then north. And so basically I'm driving all over the island, you know, and total it will take me probably the whole thing will take me 18 days, and today is on my fourth day. And as you can see now, I am filming the whole experience. So you are actually going to see the plane wreck with me now, you know, as I in the meantime I can just talk to you. You know, when I talk like this, some people sometimes they just give a weird look, because anyway, I'm not talking to myself, I'm talking to a camera and whoever is watching my video now. I am renting a car, so I'm not using any tours or something or all that kind of stuff, you know. I am on my own, and I am a solo traveler, you know. And it takes a lot to all that planning and and driving and jumping from one hotel to another, you know, that's a lot to take in, you know. And flying from all the way from California to Iceland, and then dealing with the jet lag, and then going through the whole process to rent a car and you know, when you drive all over, you know, during the ring road, that means you're gonna be checking in and accommodation and then checking out, then again checking in and checking out, because you're gonna stay at so many different places as you go drive the whole island. And if I'm not mistaken, this hike walk will be approximately 45 minutes. And I see kids also walking with their parents. So and the kid is already crying. So you know, kids don't like to walk that long, you know. And this country, you know, it's a beautiful country if you are an adventurous person, you know. And but if you like the if you're a person that likes metropolitan cities and big cities, and Iceland may not be good for you. But if you are you know, a nature guy, you know, a nature person, you love to go to national parks, enjoy the nature away from the crowd, away from the cities, Iceland will be the perfect country for you to visit. And just let me turn around the camera and show you how the place looks like. And I am certainly hoping that by the time I get to the plane, there will be no crowd, because that place is very famous for you know, it's very famous because a lot of people see it on a postcard, and so many people go there to do you know, their photography stuff. And and I will be lucky if I am if I find the place empty without a crowd, so I can get an opportunity to take photos. I just want one person to see, one person just to help me take a photo for me, you know. But when you see so many people around you, you don't get a good photo. You know, it's been 45 minutes into the walk, and finally got to the DC3 plane wreck. And and I don't know, it might take you more to you know, or less, since everybody walks at a different pace. But for me, it took me 45 minutes just one way. So just plan ahead if you if you're planning on visiting this particular site. And much to my delight, the weather is beautiful today. Beautiful. It cannot get any better than this. You see, this is unusual for you know, for the weather in Iceland to be warm and sunny, you know. And I don't know how I would manage my my hike to this plane if it were snowing or raining or windy. And the wind is not that bad today. It's cooperating well. I see a bunch of people here sitting on the wing, and I am not sure if I could get inside and give you a view of what the plane is like from the inside. You see, this is wow. I think I am not supposed to get inside, but here you go, folks. I already came all the way here, and why not just go inside and show you. And this is this place is called Sólheimasandur beach. This is in the south coast region in Iceland, and just up ahead that's the Atlantic Ocean, you know. You know, it's very amazing when you know, when I look at the map, almost every day when I was home back in California. I see the map of the world, and I see that little country all the way up, located up, and that place, that country is Iceland. And now I am standing here, you know, on the land of Iceland. It's just amazing, amazing, you know. And I am really, really happy to see the weather cooperating with me today. The first few days when I got here, it was horrible weather. The weather was so horrible, raining and windy, and wasn't good at all. And you see a lot of people are taking photos on Instagram, and there used to be a shuttle that comes all the way here, but I think they canceled it due to the pandemic. And imagine if there is a shuttle tour company that come here. This I would imagine this place will be very, very crowded. So I think it's better if they just let people hike all the way here and make the efforts to come here, because I would imagine it would be less crowded if they only allow you know, adventurous people to come to this spot. You know, I had the opportunity to take a lot of photos, and I even jumped all the way up to take some photos, and now I'm gonna wrap up this video, and let me turn around the camera as usual to say goodbye. And the next destination, I'm gonna go to a place called Dairihulai, and it's actually 10 minutes drive, or about 15 minutes drive from the parking lot, and it's actually located all the way along the coast over there. And now now it's gonna take me about 45 minutes just to hike back all the way to the parking lot. Just keep in mind, if you're planning to visit this particular site, it took me 45 minutes one way and then another 45 minutes to go back. So, and I spent the better part of an hour just sitting here, just waiting for the crowd to go, so to get an opportunity to take photos. And I'm lucky. I don't know about you. I'm lucky today. The weather is nice, you know, and I would imagine it would be very difficult to hike to this place if it's raining, or if it's snowing, or if it's even windy. So, but today, much to my delight, it was so good. The weather treated me very, very well. And for now, I hope you really enjoyed this video. And for now, I would say goodbye and have a wonderful, wonderful day.